And you wouldn't probably go to the women. And she said, yes, sir. And I said, you remember when the social worker introduced you to us? You were around the corner and saw me and ran and jumped in my arms. And you said, my big daddy. And you grabbed me and said, my big daddy won't let anybody hurt me. And I said, big daddy's still here, but big daddy can't stop his cancer, but big daddy can stop it from hurting me. And she said, okay, dad, we know what we have to do. I had no idea I was going to be doing that. So just before all that happened, here's what she told me to preach. And I just thought I would just share it with y'all, because if nobody else needs it, I do right now. And that is, I told Bethany, I said, we can't live with our hand on the panic button. We can't live all the time wondering what's getting ready to happen, be afraid of every next move. I know cancer is a scary word, and it's like every time we turned around, they were trying another treatment. They were switching directions. They were changing the medicine. She was like on 30 drugs, and the drugs kept changing, and we were trying to keep it in order and getting up at certain times in the morning and night to make sure she had her medicine and all this stuff going on. But like I told Bethany, I said, Bethany, we have a choice. We've had it before now. We've got it now. We can live by fear, or we can live by faith. I'm telling us right now, we can live by fear, or we can live by faith. The choice is ours, not Satan's, not God's. It's our choice. And Bethany said, amen, Daddy. I choose to live by faith. I said, girl, we're going all the way with this thing. We're riders to the ground, baby. We're not going to go in fear. We're going to go in faith. She says, yes, sir, Daddy, we are. And I said, let me just tell you something about fears, baby. She said, what is it? I said, number one, F, fear is from Satan. E, it's energized by lies. A, it always comes with a choice. And R, you have to refuse to accept it. She says, Daddy, I refuse to accept it. And about that time, the ladies that were working to her said, we refuse to accept it too, preacher. Come on, preach. Come on, preach. Of course, I was feeling a whole lot better then, and I was a little bit more animated. So forgive me if I'm not so animated right now, but that's okay. And she said, well, Daddy, what's faith? And I said, here it is, baby, faith. F is from God. A is always based on truth. I is inspirational. T is trust. You have to trust him in the test. And H, you can hide in it, and it always helps. And she says, Daddy, I'm hiding. I wanted to tell all of us to hide, but we couldn't. And then here it was. I just told her this. And then the doctor came in and talked to me. I said, baby, there's something you don't have to fear right now. She says, well, I said, Daddy, I said, you don't have to fear death. Philippians 1:21 says, to die or to live is Christ, and to die is gain. And she said, amen, Daddy, I don't have to fear death, and I don't. I said, you don't have to fear failure in all of this. Whatever we've done, if it feels like it's falling apart, it's okay, because we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. You don't have to fear about where you're going or what's going to happen now or what's going to happen later on, because my God shall supply all your need according to his riches and glory. And you don't have to fear the future or the unknown, baby, because God is always with you. Bethany, in her little big voice, said, amen, Daddy. Preach, Daddy. Preach. Preach, Daddy. Preach. And then I heard all these care partners going, preach it, Pastor. Preach it, Pastor. And Bethany said this with me. I said, Bethany, you know there's no fear in love. Perfect love casts out all fear, Beth. Because fear has torment. And he that feareth is not made perfect in love. I said, I want you to repeat something after me. And she said, okay, Daddy. And I said, repeat it, Bethany. She did. I had to wait a little bit, but she repeated. I said, Bethany, here it is. I will live without fear because God is with me. And she said, Daddy, I will live without fear because God is with me. I said, Bethany, not God was with me, not he will be with me, but God is with me. She said, Daddy, God is with me. I said, baby, I got to hear it one more time. I will not live or live without fear because I know that you are with me. I'm surely and I'm always will be with you to the very end of this world. We have no idea that yesterday would be Bethany's last day on this earth. But I can tell you this. As soon as she let go of our hands, she took hold of God's hand. And when she left her, she couldn't walk. She couldn't even talk. But as soon as she went to the other side, I'm pretty sure if I could have heard it. She is rejoicing now. Her, Mama Beverly, Grandma Linton, Buttons, and they said, don't forget Uncle Ralph. just before he died, and I probably looked over at Bethany and said, you know what? You and I have an advantage of everybody else in this room. And Beth said, how's that, Uncle Ralph? He says, because we're going to see Jesus sooner than any one of these people. She said, he said, we win. I will not fear because God is with me. I'll say that.
I will not fear because God is with me.
We're going to get ready to close up, but I want to tell you something. Bethany wanted to do something for cancer. We got talking about it. Bethany loved the idea. And I'm going to get you some stuff for this so you can go ahead and put it in there. But Bethany, right now, in the Relay for Life, Bethany is number one already. Mm-hmm. Team Bethany is number one in the Relay for Life for cancer research. And she would have been 28 this year. And so we talked to her about all this, and she said this is what she wanted to do, this is what she wanted. And so we come up with the goal, but she liked the goal too. And so we're going to try to raise $2,800 in honor of her 28th birthday for cancer research. And also there's luminaries you can get. And so I'm not here playing on your emotions. I'm here just saying that if you want to do something for Bethany to honor her, you can. She knows how she always gave. Mm-hmm. She gave constantly. Everything. She just gave and gave and gave and gave and gave. And even in her death, she said, I want to help others with cancer. And I don't know about you. I'm already doing it, but I'm going to do even more. But I'm saying this. Let's honor her. Mm-hmm. Also, when I'm talking about her in the past tense, because she's still alive. She's more alive now than she's ever been.
Amen.
The difference is she doesn't have that great big thing under her arm, and she doesn't have problems trying to eat. And all that stuff, now she's walking and talking and having a good time. Bethany is whole. She's alive. She is well. Just before she died, a day or two before she died, DC was in there by himself with her. And she hadn't talked in hours. And she said, DC, come here. Startled him. He walked over to her. And she grabbed it by the hand, and she said, look over there. And DC looked there and said, there's Mama. Beverly, there she is. So she's looking at us, and she's smiling. And DC said, I don't see her. She said, there she is right there. She's looking at us, and she's smiling. And DC said he still didn't see her, but he felt something around. And then said she just looked up and followed something up. And she said, she's gone. Well, you know what? Yesterday, that same trip was taken by Bethany. She's not here in present, but she's here in our hearts. And I don't know about you, but I'll never forget that rascal. There's two things that I know she loved. Three things, actually. She loved her family. Lord knows she loved her family. She loved God. She loved the church. And she loved the mass. And so we're going to do some things to honor her in all of this. And so remember, if you want to honor her, cancer research, just put it through Team Bethany. That'll be the cool thing, and it can be for Bethany. But don't wait for her. I heard her this morning. Here, it's clean. I wasn't sure, because I wasn't sure I was coming. DC said, let's go. I said, all right, let's go. And when I got here, all I could hear constantly was, don't weep for me, Dad. Don't weep for me, Dad. Don't weep for me. I'm well. So I'm telling you, just don't think about all the sad. Think about all the good. Think about her picture of Grace under fire. The best picture I've ever seen anywhere of Grace under fire. And then she always loved, as I say, she's perfectly, the perfect picture of Grace, but she can still make the poke cuts. And she'd say, Daddy, tell him about Mother Teresa. I go, okay. And she'd also make Mother Teresa want to kick the habit. And she said, tell them about the cardinals. I said, okay, Bethany. She had the Pope so aggravated and confused, he wouldn't just cuss, he wouldn't strangle three or four cardinals. And maybe some of them might even be birds. What I want to do right now, because I know everybody's hurting, and we've all been through this, we're all been there. So what I want to do is I just want everybody just to Find somebody beside you, hold their hand. I know Bethany enough to know she don't want you weeping over her. She wants you rejoicing for her. Cancer didn't win. She won. It still doesn't seem real, but we know she's gone to heaven with God. We do know that. So right now, everybody holding hands for somebody. I want you to lift them up. God, we don't understand your plan so many times. And God, we don't even understand sometimes if we're even in your plan, even though we know you're working it all the time. God, you say you're working everything for our good. And we just have to trust you right now. That part of the plan in Bethany's life, although she faced a lot of pain and heartache her entire life, being abused and all the things that happened and being in operations and all this stuff, she went through so much. But God, we know that she's lived four or five lifetimes in that 27 years. And God, I also know that she showed the perfect picture of grace under fire this last year. Father, I just hope that I could be as strong as her if I was ever faced with something as scary as cancer. I ask you right now, Lord, to help us not to think about all the bad things, not think about all the pain and heartache. If we do, just remember to coat it with, on the other end, the love. Bethany loved every one of us. She showed it all the time. I ask you right now, Lord, to help us show that love to each other right now, as Bethany would show it to us. In the name of Jesus, help us to think of the good things, to remember the good things, and to do something positive to honor her memory. Because I know, God, you've got this. You've got this. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
All right, we're going to stop it right here. We got something going. We got another service coming up here shortly. Remember, I'm not sure what's going on yet. It looks like maybe the service will be next Sunday, and it'll be here. That was her dream. She had a dream, and in her dream, this church was packed with all ages, all races. It was packed, and she saw us. Saw what was going on, and she was so excited, and she was loving it, and she was just, she said, "Daddy, I was so excited. I've never been this excited." And the Lord talked to me and told me, said, "That's her funeral." And so I'd ask her about it along the way. "Tell me about that dream again." And she'd tell me about that dream so I could get things together. And so next Sunday, I'm pretty sure next Sunday around 2 o'clock, we're going to have her service here, visitation before. But y'all, make sure that when you're talking, make sure you talk about the good things. Okay? Because that's all she liked to talk about was the good things. Amen? God's awesome.
All the time. God is awesome.
Everybody, let's stand. Real Steve.